Have you ever wanted to learn to play an instrument? Maybe you heard a song on the radio and thought, I want to play that on the guitar. When you set out to learn it, it turns out that it's pretty hard. You have to start with all the chords, all the basics of the instrument, and they can take time to learn and be kind of frustrating. But the payoff comes when you put them all together and you can play that song. Well, learning physics is kind of like that. And the basics of physics is pretty much math. And so in this lesson, we'll dive into algebra to learn a few things that will really help you as we move forward in this class. Let's take a look. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson agenda. First, we'll solve an example of an equation with one variable. Then we'll solve an example problem with two variables where one variable has a known value. So basically, there's two things that can vary and we know one of them. Then we'll build even further and solve an example problem with multiple variables where all but one variable has a known value. So we're going to build in complexity slowly here. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to plug in values for variables which are given, isolate the unknown variable you are trying to solve for, and use order of operations to solve for that isolated variable. First, let's talk about isolating a variable. To isolate something means to get that variable all by itself. That means it doesn't have any numbers near it or any mathematical operators like plus and minus. It's all by itself. So, for example, when 3x equals 6, that x is not isolated. The x there is the variable, and it's not alone. It's with a 3. So that x is not isolated. Meanwhile, over here, we've rearranged the equation slightly. We'll talk about how to do this in just a second. And now x is all by itself. It's isolated. X is equal to 6 over 3, and the x is alone. All right, how do we get things by themselves? How do we rearrange things? It all has to do with inverse operations. To isolate a variable, you use inverse operations. What does that mean? Well, that means to undo addition, you're going to do subtraction. So we do the opposite of what's being done to a variable in the problem. To undo multiplication, well, you'll do division. Whatever you do to one side of the equation, you must do to the other side. That's just the golden rule of algebra. Okay, so whenever you do one thing to one side of the equation, you have to do that exact same thing to the other side. Let's take a look at our 3x equals 6 example. How did we get x by itself? Well, currently, 3 is being multiplied by x. So what do we need to do to get rid of it? What do you think? If you guess divide, you're exactly right. We have to divide both sides by 3. Notice I divided the left side by 3 and the right side by 3. That's just following that really important rule where whatever we do to one side, we gotta do it to the other. Now those 3s cancel out and we get x is equal to 6 over 3, which if we divide 6 by 3, we get 2. So we've isolated the variable using inverse operations so that we can actually solve for its value. Let's put this to work with a few examples. Our first example is an equation with just one variable. We're going to look at 2x plus 3 equals 10. So that x there is a variable. The 2, 3, and 10 we call constants. When we go to solve a problem like this, it's important to remember that we should remove constants being added or subtracted before removing those being multiplied or divided. The only exception to that is if you see parentheses or fractions floating around. Okay, so here x is not isolated. It's not by itself. It's being multiplied by 2, and 3 is being added to it. Which one should we get rid of first? The 3, because it's being added or subtracted. How do we do that? What do you think? Well, if it's being added, we need to subtract. We need to subtract 3 from both sides. Then the plus 3 and minus 3 add together to give us 0. They cancel out. The 10 minus 3 gives us 7, so we have 2x equals 7. Now, to isolate x, we need to realize that 2 is being multiplied by x. So we have to do the opposite. What's the opposite of multiplication? It's division. So we divide both sides by 2. Again, now the 2 divided by 2 goes away. That divides to 1. And we get x equals 7 over 2, which is the same as 3.5. In physics, lots of times we'll get answers that have a decimal place, and that's totally great. So don't think that your answers need to be a whole number. Okay, now we'll increase the complexity just a bit. We'll do equations with two variables. So here we have y equals 1/2 x minus 5. We're also told that y is equal to 8. And so the very first step here is to plug in values for our known variables. In this case, we know y. It's equal to 8. So we'll plug it in. And then we get 8 equals 1/2 x minus 5. All right, step 2 is to isolate the unknown variable. We got to get x all by itself. What should we do first? Well, x is having 5 subtracted from it. And so we got to get rid of that by adding 5 to both sides. When we add 5 to both sides, we get 13 equals 1/2 x. Now here is another place where we can get stuck, because we have a fraction. And fractions are nobody's best friend, let's be honest, right? How do we get rid of that? Well, we can always get rid of a fraction by multiplying the whole equation by the denominator. In this case, that is 2. So the denominator is just the thing on the bottom of the fraction. So when we multiply both sides by 2, that 2 goes away. And thankfully, we get rid of our fraction. The last thing to do is just to use the orders of operations to solve for our variable. So 2 times 13 gives us 26 is equal to x. Awesome. One more example problem. This one is for equations with multiple variables. And we're going to plug in, simplify, isolate, and solve. So let's do that. Here we're told 2a plus b equals 3c minus d. And look at all we're given. We're given so many values. We're told that b is 4, c is 2, and d is 1. The only thing we don't know is a. And that is another important rule in algebra. To be able to solve a problem, we have to have all the variables but one. Just one unknown variable if we're dealing with one. Okay, let's plug in those variables. We get 2 times a, and the pink there, a, is just left in our equation because we don't know a. That's what we're trying to solve for. B is in blue there, shown as plus 4, equals 3 times 2, so we plugged in the value for c, which is 2, and then we have minus 1. Notice the minus 1 there is because we had a negative sign in our original equation. So even though d is equal to 1, when I subtract d, I get minus 1. Okay, so we get 2a plus 4 equals 3 times 2 minus 1. And now we start to simplify. 3 times 2 is 6, minus 1 is 5. So we get 2a plus 4 equals 5. So now we've plugged things in, and we've simplified them. Next, we got to isolate. How are we going to isolate this? Well, 2a plus 4. Two things are happening there. We're adding 4, and we're multiplying by 2. We want to get rid of the thing that's being added or subtracted first. So I'm going to get rid of the 4. It's being added right now, so I have to subtract it. That means when I subtract 4 from both sides, I'll get 2a equals 1. Awesome. Now, how do I get a by itself? A is currently being multiplied by 2, so I need to divide both sides by 2. So I get a equals 1/2. And now I can go ahead and reduce that to a decimal, which would be 0.5. All right, we're going to now go through 3 practice problems that you get to do. So pause the video and work on this one till you find the answer. You've been given a couple variables and an equation. Okay, did you get it? Here, we're going to plug in and get 3 equals x over 4. We're going to isolate by multiplying 4 by both sides, and then we'll solve for x equals 12. All right, practice problem 2. Try this one out. If you didn't get the last one, no big deal. Try again. Pause the video. In this case, we're going to plug in for g, 10, and for n, 1.5, leaving m as our unknown. We'll divide both sides by 1.5, and here we've just started to use x instead of m because x is a really comfortable unknown. So sometimes we do that in physics. We'll say, you know what, I don't want to deal with this weird letter. Let's just call it x because that's going to make my life a little easier looking. So totally fine. Now we know that 10 divided by 1.5 is x. So x is roughly equal to 6.7. So what is the value of m? Approximately 6.7. In this video, we've learned how to solve equations with one variable, how to solve equations with two variables where we have to plug in a value for one of them, and how to solve equations with multiple variables where all but one variable is known. Hey, hey.